In Lightroom, we have texture, clarity, and dehaze. But what are they? What are the differences between them? And more importantly, how should you use them to edit your images? Let's discover all of those answers right now. All right, so you're gonna find texture, clarity, and dehaze grouped together in the basics panel of Lightroom Classic or in the effects section of Lightroom and Lightroom Mobile. And just so you know, they all work exactly the same regardless of the version of Lightroom that you use. And they're grouped together because they have some similarities and their primary purpose is to reduce or create depth and detail in your photos depending on how you apply them. So adjusting the sliders to the right will create depth and will enhance detail. To the left, it has the opposite effect. And the reason why you need three editing tools to refine the detail in your image is that each of them affects your image slightly differently. So let's review each one and learn how they work and how you can apply them. And I'm gonna give you some creative pro tips along the way. All right, so of the three, texture is going to be the most subtle. And that's due to the detail that it targets in your image, which is medium-sized detail. So when you increase or decrease texture, it's not affecting the fine, teeny tiny details. So this is perfect for portraits when you want to create a softer mood or want to, let's say, soften the skin. I also use it for boosting the details in landscape and wildlife images as well. But how much I apply is slightly different for each subject. For portraits, I like to keep it to right around plus or minus 5 to 10. Now for everything else, I might boost it a little bit more. It all depends on the image and the amount of detail and depth that I want to add or remove. All right, so clarity alters the detail in your image differently compared to texture. So it's going to target or it affects the contrast along the edges of the details in the mid-tone area of the tonal range. All right, I know that's a mouthful. And if you're new to photography and or editing, it simply means that it's targeting one out of five tonal ranges or brightness levels in your image. So real quick, if you navigate to your histogram and hover your mouse on the far left side, it's going to highlight that tonal range and then underneath it, it says blacks. So that's the first of five tonal ranges in your image. Now, next to that, we have shadows and then in the middle of all the tonal ranges are the midtones, which is where clarity is targeting the details. And then after that, you have your highlights and whites. So when you apply clarity, it's going to, in most cases, have a bigger effect on your image compared to texture. And overall, if you increase it, the details in the midtones get enhanced or the contrast in that tonal range is boosted, which will make your image pop or appear sharper, both really. And decreasing clarity is going to make your image look softer. Now, when it comes to portraits, I tend to use this less since it can create an unnatural look if you apply it too much. But if you want a gritty or grungy type of look, then clarity can provide that creative option as you reach the maximum intensity. And it might be more useful though, based on the subject and your personal preference, of course. Now, here's a cool trick for portraits. Let's say you have some clothing or something else in the image you'd like to add some clarity to, but you don't want to affect the skin of your subject. Well, in that case, you can use your adjustment brush to target that area of your image, and then your clarity adjustment will be applied only to that part of your image. How cool is that? I love it. Now, for wildlife and landscapes, I tend to use it a little bit more based on my editing style. And again, it's a personal preference and you have to decide for yourself how much clarity to apply based on your editing style. So dehaze targets a slightly larger tonal range than clarity. So the midtones and a little bit of the shadows and highlights, just enough so you don't blow out the highlights or muddy the shadows. So the Dehaze tool's primary purpose is to eliminate or minimize fog, mist, or haze in your image, or you can add a little bit of haze if you're looking for a new creative option. Now, you might be surprised that clarity, texture, and dehaze are, come a little closer, a little more. They're the secret ingredient to overexposed skies. So watch this video right here to see the proper way to use them when you have overexposed skies.